going to ask a question on artificial intelligence.
Oh.
I've heard that could be a useful tool maybe in that industry as well
yes.
as others. So I wondered what you thought of it and how do you think, you know, it should be developed and used?
So this is another one of those areas where I do think a leader from the next generation who AI is going to impact, is already impacting, and who also understands actually the unique challenges, this goes beyond partisanship, is necessary in the next president. So I actually have used AI in the drug company that I founded to discover new medicines. It was part of where the puck was going. And I think AI can have a lot of good uses in this country. But there are also real risks. The real risks is when it comes to interfacing with people. People's interface with AI, especially kids. So here's how I think about AI policy broadly. Are there risks? Yes. But we cannot adopt blanket bans in this country if China isn't adopting those same bans either. Think about that. We banned gain-of-function research, but they still did in Wuhan. That created a pandemic that the U.S. suffered from. So we have to learn our lessons. No bans, especially if China's not willing to adopt the bans. But we also have to make companies responsible for the decisions they make. So just like you can't dump your chemicals if you're a chemical company in somebody else's river, well, if you're developing an AI algorithm today that has a negative impact on other people, you bear the liability for it. Well, that would make companies like Microsoft and Meta take that into account now. Rather than the government doing it, command and control, those companies, because they bear the liability, those companies would then take that into account now. That's not happening today. And that's a very pragmatic solution. You haven't heard it from either party, but that's the kind of solution we're going to need to be able to make sure we're not banning something that could have good uses, but cause companies to take into account the risks that they face. And a final thought I'll leave with you on AI is, so I'm a tennis fan, okay? I used to watch professional tennis. I was a ball boy. That was my first job I ever had. The line judges used to be human beings. Today, the line judges are AIs, not made by human beings. But in the first generation of the AI, you know what you could see? It would make wrong calls. You could just see it with your eyes. But John McEnroe and Jimmy Connors, they used to argue with the line judges. Well, now when the AI starts making the call, what happened? Even if it's a bad call, they stop arguing. So what does that say? Now you go to ChatGPT, just try typing it in. How do you fight climate change or racial injustice? It gives you a factual answer as though it was converting Fahrenheit to Celsius. That's the real danger of AI, is that people bend the knee to a new master. And this is a longer conversation, but one of the best ways to protect ourselves against the risks of AI is actually to revive true faith in this country, faith in God. And that's a longer conversation. But that's something that if I'm getting to the truth of the matter, that's an important part of the conversation we need to be having.